So let's jump into our charts here. I'm going to walk you through a few of these, and then we'll hear from Supervisor Vargas, and Drs. McDonald and Wooten are here for Q&A. What you see here on the COVID dashboard is the total dosages shipped to our region, and then the total dosages that have been administered. You see first shot and second shot. And again, we know 357 is what we're reporting on our total dosages. We know the state database has us over 380,000. We know that the number is north of the 357, but and we're working to increase the speed at which those numbers reflect. Delta that you see between total dosages administered and total shipped, some of that reports things that have been shipped, perhaps not received, or things that are being held back for scheduled appointments that are coming in the coming days. But we expect that total dosages number to increase. We know that it is significantly higher than what's represented there. But again, a considerable step forward. 10% of our population 16 and older have received at least their first dosage, and 2% of our population 16 and older are fully vaccinated. And again, as the supply increases, we will be able to increase those. Let's go to our next chart. What you see right here on the map is just the location of the current county and partner pods which are in place. You will notice that most all of them now we have opened up a considerable number. We have two of them that are future ones that are coming, one that is developing in Escondido, and then one that's coming in the North Coastal area, and those are ones that should be coming on within the next week. And then what we'll really be doing is just standing poised and ready to increase the throughput at each of these sites. Again, we have about double the capacity to administer vaccines that we actually have vaccines in place. Next slide. This is just the long-term care facilities. Again, you see just over 1,300. 911 of those facilities have received at least their first dosage, either through our partnership with our fire departments or through the partnership with the pharmacies. And we know that hundreds more are scheduled. And we think that we will be able to get through all of those in the coming days. Next, we'll go to our cases. Again, a second consecutive day below 1,000, and this is encouraging. You got to go back to the end of November where we had a single day under 1,000, and so we are encouraged by this trend. But again, we want to remind the public we have new, more contagious strains that are out there, and this is not a time where we can lose our focus. We need these numbers to continue to come down. We want to descend into the red tier. We want to get more things open, more opportunities for our community, make it easier for our schools to open, for our kids to get back playing sports and our small businesses. So this should motivate us to really double down on what we are doing and continue those efforts so that we can continue this downward trajectory. But the combination of being on the leading edge of number of vaccines administered and the decline in cases should give us a sense of hope that things right now are headed in the right direction, but a hope that motivates us to do more, not less. Next chart. Again, hospitalization numbers, you know, these are going to lag the decline in cases. You know, we know that there is a lag until we see that, but generally speaking, trending down ever so slightly day over day. And I know this is welcome news to our hospital systems to have those COVID numbers continue to trend down very, very slightly, but again, trending in the right direction. Next. The ICU capacity, you see, you know, the box right there is staffed and immediately available, and people say, why is this not moving given the cases are coming down? And again, as the COVID ICUs took up a greater share of available ICUs, non-COVID ICU had procedures delayed or rescheduled, and so now our healthcare systems are going to be for a while trying to catch up a backlog of a lot of those things that were able to delay, and so we don't think we'll see much considerable change in this number, even though we are headed in a better direction overall with cases and generally with COVID-related hospitalizations. And then, unfortunately, we report today 54 additional fatalities ascribed to COVID-19, brings our total to 2,683. And our final chart here just shows where we are in the tiered system. Again, you see that both the unadjusted case rate and the adjusted case rate are both trending down. You can see our unadjusted case rate from just a few weeks ago in the middle of January was at almost 90, then it was over 90 We've now cut it down to 50. The adjusted case rate, again, takes into account the testing, and we continue to do more than average number of testing, so we get some credit on the adjustment coming down, our percentage of positive also coming down, and our health equity testing percentage of positive coming down. But you also see that we've got a ways to go to get down to that next tier in red, which is why we continue to stress with the public that we really have to be mindful and follow all of the advice that's out there. So bottom line, good news on vaccines in terms of our ability to get shots in arms, good news on the direction of our cases, but that should motivate us to remain vigilant and continue the positive direction of motion. And again, on vaccines, the limiting factor is just the supply and availability of vaccines, and we hope that that increases very soon, and when it does increase, we are well positioned to be able to immediately ramp up the distribution of those.